Every witch has a book of shadows, and a book of shadows is something that we all like to start using as soon as we become familiar with the craft and we know that this is the path that we want to walk. And a book of shadows is that place where we keep all of our reference material to the spell work that we're doing, the correspondence lists that we're doing, the planetary associations, the different types of scripts that we might use for our spells. Anything to do with magic, rituals, sabbats, goes in the Book of Shadows. It's a reference book. But a shadow work journal is a different thing. Hi, I'm Sandra from MysteryWitchSchool.com, and if you want to walk the witchcraft and Wiccan path and you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button below so that you don't miss anything. This video is about the shadow work journal, how it differs to your book of shadows, and some of the things that you can do with it. So shadow work for me is about your inner work, your self-knowledge, the know thyself part of the magical path, and also the work that you do on your inner self, which is really your subconscious mind, to be able to feel better about yourself, love yourself, accept yourself, so that you can do what you came here to planet Earth to do, which is your great work in a magical sense. We call it the great work. So whatever your aim is, whatever your purpose is, even if you don't know what that is yet, it's a part of what you discover when you do shadow work. So shadow work is all about what you can't see about yourself. It's in the shadows. That's why it's called shadow work. It's in the shadows. You can't see it. So you go in with owl eyes, because owls see in the shadows, and you start to shine a light too on the shadows so that you can see these parts of yourself and they're revealed. There'll be parts of yourself that are shoved into the shadow because you don't want to see them. Society doesn't want to see them. Your family doesn't want to see them. Your friends don't even want to see them. And they're also things that shadow work is all about, helping you understand, integrating into your light side of your personality so that you can stand fully in your truth, stand fully in your power, and express who you really are. So having a shadow work journal is important for this process. And a shadow work journal isn't necessarily any different to your normal journal. If you're a journaler and you like to do journaling, so writing about things that you're experiencing on a daily basis, how you feel, how you think, what you've experienced, how you've reacted to things, these can all be part of your shadow work journal, because anything that you're experiencing emotionally in your life and thought ways in your life is important to the shadow work, because shadow work is all about you and what's going on inside you. So a shadow work journal, I've got a lot of that I've found over the years. These are the journals that I've used for shadow work, and they come in all different shapes and sizes, depending on, of course, what I could find when I needed a new journal. And there's quite a lot of history in these books, a lot of psychological inquiry. Now, most of these books were, I was writing in before I really understood a lot of the more modern processes that we can use to help us shift things in our psyche. So a lot of it is just writing down our thoughts, feelings, and things that I've seen going on inside my own psyche, doing some processes that I've read from books. All kinds of things have gone into my shadow work journal, and all of it is helpful. So what I want to do is just give you a few things that you can put in your journal to get you started. So one of the first things that you can do is do what's called a black and white mirror. And I think I have mentioned this before on previous videos on shadow work, where you write down a list, and I can't remember which journal it's in to show you, you write down a list of as many traits that you have that you don't like about yourself, or anything you've been told is bad about yourself, and you feel maybe shame about or guilt about. Write them down. And then also, after you've done that and spent some time doing that, you do the opposite of that, and you write down all of the qualities you like about yourself, that you've been told are great about yourself, that are socially acceptable about yourself. And if you're like a lot of people, particularly if you're a person who is somebody who's been told that you should always doubt yourself, that you should always put your other people ahead of yourself, you may find that your negative qualities of your dark mirror, there's a lot more of them than what you can put down in your light mirror. And that's not because you have less light qualities than you do dark qualities. It's just that you're editing yourself and you are focused more on what you don't like rather than what you do like about yourself. And what needs to happen is to change that over so that you're actually feeling better about all of yourself and finding the gifts in the dark side and being able to then transfer the gifts in the dark side into the light side so that you're bringing a balance. And this is really what walking the witch path is. We walk between the worlds. So this is also the poles, the polarity. We're not fluffy up one end of the, you know, the shining light side of things, because we understand that nature doesn't work that way and the universe doesn't work that way. There is shadows and there's light for a reason, and there's strength in both. So it's understanding these parts of ourselves. So you've got your black mirror, or your dark mirror and your light mirror. Those of you who are familiar with Franz Barden's work will understand this is what he called them, the black mirror and the white mirror. And once you have those lists, then you can start working on the things you're not happy about in yourself. The things that you are happy about don't need to be worked on because you're already there with those. But it's the things that you're not happy about that can be worked on. One of the first things that I like to do with things, apart from using processes like emotional freedom technique or tapping, which I use now mostly for shadow work than anything else, or some gestalt processes, if you're actually wanting to do journaling processes, there's what I call the what does it mean ladder. So this is where you would write down something that's not working for you in your life, or something you're not happy about in your life, something you're struggling with in your life that you can't see clearly about. It's in the shadows. So it's not just qualities about yourself that you don't like that you can do shadow work on. It can be decisions that you're wanting to make to get clarity on something. Because if you can't make a decision about something, it's generally because there's a belief underneath that that may be causing you to doubt yourself and to doubt that you can make the right decision. So shadow work can be about that too. So you write down what you're struggling with. You write down maybe a quality you don't like about yourself, something that's not working for you, and you do what's called a what does it, if this is true, what does it mean ladder. So this is an example of one of those things where you write down, I'm trying to think of what, this one here was actually a decision that I was trying to make, where I was trying to bring in how do I merge EFT and tapping in with the Mystery Witch School, okay? Because on one hand I'm teaching Wicca and witchcraft, but how do I bring EFT and the transformational work into this? So I was struggling with trying to bring the two together. So the first thing I wrote down was, I don't know how to merge EFT with Witch School. And I know that the struggle that I'm having with that is to do with stuff that's still in the shadow. It's to do with stuff possibly around self-doubt, maybe I'm afraid of something. What is it that's stopping me from being able to creatively bring these things together? Because they don't have to be different. So I went down and did, yes, if this is true, what does it mean? So when I say I don't know how to merge EFT with Witch School, if this is true, what does it mean? It means that I don't know how to say I'm from mysterywitchschool.com, yet also talk about EFT. If this is true, what does it mean? I don't know what Witch School has to do with EFT. If this is true, what does it mean? It's the name of the website, and I haven't got my glasses, so I can't actually read what I've said, but it's to do with the service offering and which the EFT falls under. So basically I went down and did this, if this is true, what does it mean ladder? And so I write the first sentence, the arrow, I'll do the arrow when I say to myself, if this is true, what does it mean? And then go to the next sentence. So you're speaking to just allow your free thought to come through, because you're wanting to hear your subconscious tell you the answers to these questions. Don't consciously think of the answers. Allow your subconscious mind to tell you what the answers are. Till you get all the way through all sorts of things coming up out of it. To in the end, it turns out that the big block was that I was fearful that people are going to see the Witch School and be afraid of working with me because people are afraid of witchcraft. So this is where the if this is true, what does it mean comes from. So it came from, again, the persecution complex around being a witch or being a Wiccan. So once I know that, then I can work with that. Okay, I can tap around it, I can work with what the fear is, you know, I can be a witch and work with transformation and be safe at the same time, doing some work around that. But the if this is true, what does it mean ladder is just a really good way for you to get clear about what is really going on with anything to do with what you're feeling. And I've done a lot of these, and often it's ended up being the very last thing was that it means that I'm not worthy. And a lot of people will come to that at the end of that ladder where they'll see the belief, I'm not worthy. And so then there are processes that you can use to work on that belief that you're not enough or not worthy. So that's an example of the, if that's true, what does it mean ladder that you can put in your journal to start you off with the shadow work. And you can do that process with each of the things that you write down about yourself that you don't like. So for example, if you write down on that list, I can be very selfish sometimes, okay, and you don't feel good about being selfish because you're told it's bad to be selfish, and you also don't want to hurt people's feelings, yet at the same time you want to take care of yourself and not be a doormat for people. So you put that at the top. I feel I'm selfish and it feels bad. If that's true, what does it mean? It means I'm a bad person. If that's true, what does that mean? And then list the things under that, and you'll realize that your fear of the selfishness is to do with other people's opinions of you and the fear of what will come out of that for you if people see you as being selfish. You know, you will be, people won't like you, and you want people to like you. You want to be part of a community. You want to fit in. And if people think you're selfish, they're not going to accept you. So you'll feel like you're not enough. You're not good enough, not worthy enough. These sorts of things. So this is where you can find what the root beliefs are. And then when you get to what the root belief is, for example, I'm not enough, you can then use the processes such as EFT. I've got another video that's about tapping on shame and shamanic tapping that you can watch, and you can use those processes to help you then work your way out of the belief that you're not enough. And that's probably the number one belief that most of us have that stop us from actually expressing who we really are in the world in a way that's really positive and beneficial for everybody. Let me know in the comments field how you go with that. Let me also know what you do when you're doing shadow work, some of the processes that you may have tried yourself. Pretty much with your shadow work journal, you can also put your dreams in there and work with your dreams in your shadow journal, because dreams are very related to how you're feeling and how you're processing life in the moment. So most dreams, about 80 to 90% of your dreams will actually be about you and your life and your processing of stuff that's going on for you. There can also be dreams that are premonitions. There can be dreams where you're getting messages from spirit, but most of the dreams are actually about what's going on with you in here. And the dreams can really help you get clear about where you are in your life, what you need to work on, what you have successfully worked on, and how you're moving through any life changes or ways of thinking and being in your life. So put them in your shadow journal as well so that you can work on those. And I'll do a video about dream work as well coming up in the next couple of weeks. If you are at a point in your life where you are wanting to work on removing what's really keeping you stuck in your life and you're feeling like you just can't really express your true potential in the world, and you're ready to do some shadow work on yourself one-to-one, I do offer a free clarity session. It's a half hour via Zoom. I'll put the link to my calendar in the description field below this video. That's for those of you who are ready to really take your shadow work to the next level, and you're wanting to actually work one-on-one with someone to help release some of those beliefs that are really keeping you stuck in your life. I'm Sandra from MysteryWitchSchool.com. If you liked the video, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you on the next video. Blessed be.